friends, welcome to another class on English language. Last week we began the topic on creative writing. We began with poetic and precise. And I'm glad as regards your responses. The concrete poems you wrote was wonderful. Keep it up, okay? Today we are continuing with drama and prose. So what is drama? Drama is a story written primarily to be acted on stage. When you see a drama piece, know that the function or the primary place it would be better appreciated would be on the stage. We have forms of drama. We have the play, which is the one we are used to written in book form, or can be acted on the stage. We have a skit, which is normally a short comedy piece. Okay, that really puts society or a person. Okay, we have the opera, which is a mixture of music and drama. When you have a mixture of music and drama, you have your opera. We have a monologue from the name. It talks about a one person show. Okay, a monologue is where one person comes on stage and does everything itself or herself. We will have a type of drama. Will have a comedy, which is a happy ending of drama. It begins happily, ends happily. Everything is all fun. You'll have a tragedy, which begins and ends on a tragic note. Okay, everything is sorrowful, very serious, no room for smiling at all. We'll have something like The Gods Are Not In The Game, where especially when the chief character, the protagonist, okay, dies or something tragic happens to the person. If it's not the chief character, then it's not tragic, because at the end of the day, you sympathize, you begin to wish, how I wish this person didn't end up this way. And the tragedy is normally caused by the person's flaws, the person's weaknesses. Okay, then we'll have the tragic comedy. We talks about a play that begins on a happy note but ends, that begins on a tragic note but ends on a happy note. Okay, moving from there, we're looking at the features. What are the features of drama? The first one is stage direction. The stage direction is normally enclosed in brackets, okay? Sometimes after a written utterance by a character, you see something in brackets. Those things in bracket normally shows what the character is supposed to be doing or what the actor is supposed to be doing immediately after making such an utterance. It could be "Good morning, ma," and they put in brackets, "She kneels down." Okay? That means that is what you should be doing at that point. Then we'll have a list of characters. A drama begins with a list of characters, the list of people who you should be seeing and the role they should be playing in the play. Something like James, the gate man, Mr. Sadat, the postman, things like that. And then we'll have written, one of the features is that it's written to be performed. I've said that before, a drama piece is written primarily to be performed. It is written in dialogue form. This person says this, Ojo says this, Obi says this, Mary says this. In that organized form, that is called dialogue. Even if you are watching it on the TV or wherever, you discover that they do not all talk in unison. They take their turns. Dialogue. And then we'll have, it can include costuming, direction, and physical setting of a stage. Sometimes, at the beginning of a particular scene or an act, you see a kind of description of what you find. It is supposed to be like that, so that if you are going to dramatize this on stage, you should know what you expect. Sometimes they say the flower plant is by the side, it's on the table, the cushion is placed beside the window, okay? We have a picture on the wall. These are things that are written down, and they are called costuming or physical setting of a stage. When you see such a thing, if you want to stage it in your school, for example, you follow it. It is very, very important because there are some things that will be said, that will be done in the play, that will require you to sit exactly where you have been told to sit, following the direction. Okay? Sometimes in the beginning, you also see something like the kind of clothes they will wear. He comes in wearing a danshiki, an agbada, or a three-piece suit. These things are all directions, okay? Of course, costuming or physical state, physical setting of the stage. Sometimes drama piece contains that. All right, it also contains acts and scenes. The division of drama is in acts and scenes, okay? Acts and scenes, and not paragraphs and chapters. Then, we also have prose. Prose. What is a prose? It's a composition in ordinary form of a written language. It's very simple. It's the way the things are written ordinarily. Okay? Like an essay form, continuum. The person continues to say their thoughts and it doesn't break unless it's a punctuation or a paragraph or another chapter. Okay, chapters and paragraphs. That is just a normal continuous flow of a prose. We have a form of a prose, we have a fiction, which is an untrue story or an imagined one. It never happens. Okay, it never happens anywhere except in the head of the writer. Then examples, we have a myth, which is about is normally a story that is written to explain some things that happen naturally. Sometimes you have a story point to talk about the reason the tortoise has a cracked shell. Okay? They form a story to explain that. It's called a myth. They will have legends. Okay? This one talks about heroic deeds. They pick somebody and write many heroic things about that person. Okay? Then we'll have the fables about animal characters. We'll have the novels. Quite voluminous stories, okay? Novel, we have the short story, which can contain like 2 pages. Then we'll have the novella, which is found between a novel and a short story, somewhere in between. Then we'll have the non-fiction, which is true and not imagined, okay? True and not imagined. Remember I said that it is a continuous like an essay. So we'll have something that's continuous like an essay coming from a non-fiction. An example could be